She was a beautiful-hearted person who wanted to help everyone. And in the end, her kindness gets her killed.
The Lee County Sheriff says this is the hammer James Lally used to murder his girlfriend, Suzanne LaPierre. Lally confessed to the crime, then told detectives he dumped her body in some woods near Alico Road. Tonight, investigators say LaPierre wanted to end the relationship, and Lally got mad. NBC2's Gage Golding is walking us through the trail of evidence that led deputies to Lally.
Court documents from 2015 tell a very similar story. A Jacksonville woman told police that James Lally strangled her before saying he was going to kill her. Then he stole her truck and drove to Fort Myers.
A 7-year-old injunction for protection against Lally details an aggressive attack. He started strangling me again, putting a sock in my mouth. Lally's accused of punching the woman, leaving her with two black eyes before telling her, "You are done, and now I have to kill you." He was arrested after he drove 5 hours to Fort Myers. Fast forward to now, detectives say Lally brutally attacked his current girlfriend, Suzanne LaPierre. Only this time, he killed her.
He kills our victim in the bedroom of her home. He beats her to death with a hammer in the bedroom of her home.
The motive? Lally was days away from being kicked out of LaPierre's home in Century 21. Deputies say he dumped her body here in the woods off Dusty Road. Before taking off in LaPierre's car and leaving a trail of evidence, detectives found LaPierre's valuable pawned off in Sarasota. He altered the license plate to stop police from tracking him to Jacksonville.
He takes her car, he alters, he makes his own tag, and he's out of here. And he thinks he's running, but he can't hide.
He was arrested in Jacksonville and flown back to Fort Myers, where Suzanne's close friends still struggle to take in what happened to their neighbor, their friend, a sweet person.
This sort of thing is just hard to absorb.
I mean, she was a sweet person, but Susie was just too giving, too trusting.
I did reach out to Suzanne's parents tonight, who are just too distraught to talk. As for Lally, he's charged with second-degree murder. If he's convicted, he could face life in prison. I'm reporting in South Fort Myers tonight. Gage Golding, NBC2.